Flynn, you better be dying.
I'm watching you on the news.
You know, you look better from behind than you do from the front.
You're supposed to be resting.
I'm just enjoying your show.
Ask the lieutenant to have Julio meet me at the hospital.
Sharon said she would like... Hello? What?
He hung up on me.
I'll call him on my way.
You send me something to do.
You're not supposed to be working.
Please, I'm fine, really. I mean, I can watch television and work on field cards at the same time.
Patrice is standing by if you need her.
I'm good. And Slider's lawyer's coming, so...
Oh, right. And if anything goes wrong with Andy, you'll call me.
Call 911 first and then call you. Yeah.
Donna Cochran died at the scene. Chip has serious injuries and was taken to an area hospital.
Is this an accident?
Episode 9.
Oh, okay. That's where Colleen stepped up her game.
Colleen Dickhoof, sir?
Colleen
Dickhoof.
There's an ER between the dick and the hoof, Julio. And her husband's name is Les.
Colleen and Les were the couple that were giving the interview when we got to the hospital, ma'am.
Oh, she seems nice.
Oh, yeah. Sure, on the surface. Underneath, she's a snake, making passes at all the men, getting each guy to play off against the other.
In episode 9, Colleen gets her hooks in the last two husbands on the show. That would be Dr. Reggie Fluke, a computer engineer with sleep apnea.
And Chip Cochran.
Colleen was flirting with Chip, too?
On camera, in front of her husband. I mean, besides the interviews they do with the contestants, that was the best part of the show.
1 minute, this black widow is making eyes with Reggie, and the next, she's winking at Chip.
So how does all this extracurricular romance affect the game?
Because before they give you a clue to track down whatever crazy-ass item they want you to find,
each team must complete a challenge. And this Dickahoof woman, she got Chip so psyched out that he tells her on camera that he sabotaged Reggie.
You know, the computer geek?
And that he made him so late that the doctor and Mrs. Fluke could never catch up.
And then Chip and Donna drove over a cliff.
I'm telling you, it's the Dickos.
When you refer to them as a couple, shouldn't it be Dicker Hooves?
Okay. So how do we know if Colleen...
You are half a man!
Okay, that's your computer engineer with sleep apnea, Reggie Fluke, AKA the Exterminator.
And he was humiliated like this on national television.
Yeah, but don't forget, Reggie auditioned for the show knowing he was going to be on with the Cochrans.
He was hoping to win $1 million.
Not worth losing a relationship for, is it? Mm. So, how's Julio with all of this?
Not very well. Why do you ask?
Well, a woman killed in a car crash after her vehicle spins out of control?
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly how his wife died. Well, she had a seizure, but...
Oh, my God. And Julio watched the video of Donna going over the cliff. So, is that what Julio has been so upset about? Oh. Okay, we've only got 2 minutes till Patrice gets here. Let's watch this video of Reggie one more time, and I will figure out how to deal with Julio later.
Yes, ma'am.
So, Nate Olin, he was offered second-degree murder, but he's convinced that once they've had a chance to review all the episodes of American Scavenger Hunt, the jury will understand.
Too bad, because I really hated that scheming Dickahoof lady.
Hey, Mom.
Hi, Rusty. How was your interview with Slider?
Interesting. Knowing he was being filmed changed his attitude a little.
Oh, Sharon, did you figure out how to explain things to Julio?
Well, not exactly, but I think I've offered him a way to explain things to himself. And Lieutenant Provenza's going to check in on him afterwards and see how it went.